Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 2004, Running Totals. I'll be podcasting this entire book. Click that I in the top right-hand corner to subscribe. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Now, this topic in the book was contributed by my friend Zach Parise, talking about Excel tables. Zach is the world's expert on Excel tables. He's written a book about Excel tables. But first, let's talk about running totals not in tables. All right, so when I think about running totals, there's three different ways to do the running totals. And the way that I always started out with is in the first row, you just say, bring the value over. So equal whatever's to the left of me. All right, so this formula here is just equal B2. These are all formula text here on the right-hand corner, so you're seeing what we're using. And then from there on down, it's a simple little formula of equal the previous value plus the current value, right? And copy that down. But, you know, now we have this problem that it requires two different formulas, and you know, in a perfect situation, you have the exact same formula all the way down. And the reason we have to have a different formula up there in the first row is that when you try and add equal 7 plus the word total, it's a value error. But the cool workaround here is to not just use left plus up, but to use equal sum of the previous value plus the quantity in this row, and see sum is smart enough to ignore text, right? So that allows the same formula all the way down. All right, so that was when I was starting out using Excel, I was using that. And then I discovered the expanding range. The expanding range says we're going to do L, just a single dollar sign before this 2, colon L2. And what happens is this is always starting at row 2, but then it's going down to the current row. So when you look at how this works when it gets copied, we always start at row 2, but we go down to the current row. And this became my favorite method. I was like, oh, this is so much more sophisticated. And when we go into Excel options, go to the Formulas tab and choose R1C1 reference style. All right, see, in R1C1, all of these formulas are exactly the same all the way down. I don't need you to understand R1C1. It's just good to know that we have identical R1C1 formulas all the way down. Let's go back. So this method over here is the method that I liked until Charles Williams, an Excel MVP from England, who has an amazing paper on formula speed, Excel formula speed, completely debunked this method. This method, let's say you had 10,000 rows of this, every single formula is looking at two references, so you're looking at 20,000 references. But this one, this is looking at 2, this is looking at 3, this is looking at 4, this is looking at 5, and the last one's looking at 10,000 references, and it's horribly slower, and so I stopped using this method. Then I go on to read Zach and Kevin Jones's book about Excel tables, and I discover yet another problem with this method. So one of the useful features that tables offers is automatic formatting and formula maintenance as rows are added, removed, sorted, and filtered. Right, that's a quote from his book. And to add a row to a table, you just go to the very last cell in the table and press tab. All right, so everything is working here. We're down to 70, right? That's awesome. And then A104, and I'll put in 100 here. All right, so that 70 should change to 170. And it does, but this 70 shouldn't have changed at all. Right, 68 plus 2 is not 170. I'll do it again. A104, and put another 100 in. The last one is right. These two are not right. All right, so we have some weird situation that if you're using this formula and you convert over to a table and you start adding rows, the running total is not going to work. How bad is that? All right, so Zach offers two workarounds, and both of them require a little bit of knowledge of how structured references work. We're just going to add a new column out here. And if I wanted to do quantity, equal quantity, right, so that at sign quantity, the at sign says quantity in this row. Oh, cool. Well, there's another kind of reference where we use the quantity without the at. Check this out. So equal sum of quantity means all of the quantities. And we're going to say that we want to sum from the first quantity, so index quantity 1, says the first value here, down to the current row quantity. And this is using a really special version of index. When index is followed by a colon, it actually changes to a cell reference. All right, so this workaround is unfortunately violating the Charles Williams rule of we're going to have to look at every single reference. And so when you get 10,000 rows of this, it's going to go really, really slow. Zach has another workaround that doesn't violate the Charles Williams problem, but it's using the dreaded offset. Offset is a volatile function, so every time that you calculate something, the offset's going to recalculate, and everything down line from the offset's going to recalculate. It's just a great way to completely screw up your formulas. And what this is doing, it's saying we're taking the total from this row, going up one row over zero columns. And so what that's doing is saying grab the total from the previous row, and then we're adding to it the quantity from this row. All right, so now it's only looking at two references each time, but unfortunately, the offset is introducing volatile functions. Well, there you have it. More than you ever wanted to know about running totals. I guess my final opinion here is to use this method because it only looks at two, same formula all the way down, and your structured table references will work. For this explanation and 39 other really good tips, check out this book, Mr. Excel Excel, the 40 Greatest Excel Tips of All Time. Recap for this episode, we talked about three ways to do running totals. The first method has a different formula in row 2 than all the other rows. It's equal left in row 2 and then equal left plus up in rows 3 through n. But if you try and just use that same formula, equal left plus up all the way down, you're going to get a value error. So equal sum of up, comma, left, which is previous total plus this row amount. That works great, no value errors. And then the expanding range, which I used to love, they're cool, but until I read Charles Williams' white paper on Excel formula speed, then I started to hate these expanding references. It also has a problem when you use Ctrl+T and add new rows. Excel can't figure out how to expand that formula. To add new rows, I love this tip. Go to the very last cell in the table and press Tab. That'll add a new row. And then we talked about some structured referencing where we're using quantity in this row and then all quantities, the index 1 or the offset of total, go up one row above us and add current row quantity. Well, hey, I want to thank Zach for contributing that tip, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.